So let's move on to the next topic we have, which is a use case from one of the customers. And this is CNH Industrial, where we will see some exceptional customer experience with integrated cross-functional sales solution. And for this, I have with me Alberto Russo, who is a SAP project manager for CNH Industrials. Welcome to Configuration Lifecycle Management, Alberto.
Thank you. Good morning and good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon. And we are really looking forward for your presentation as well, and to see how you have created this cross-functional all over, you know, depending. I think it's related very well into the presentation we had early on with Jens Elopak as well. We say, how can you generate a cross-functional user interface and that user experience, how this will guide you? And here is a real example of how you have actually done
Yes.
it. So really looking forward for the presentation. The scene stage, over to you.
Okay. Thank you. So thank you. So today I'm introducing you the experience we had in CNH Industrial implementing our CPQ application, embedding the new ACE platform provided by Configit. Before starting, I give you just a couple of information about CNH Industrial. CNH is a company including several brands such as Case and New Holland, which are specialized in the production of vehicles in agricultural and construction sectors. Just a number, we closed last year with around $20 billion revenue. We have almost 40,000 employees shared in 42 manufacturing plants. And we sell products, I would say, almost in every country. So quite a big company with a lot of complexity, with a huge set of products that are offered among the world. So our CLM journey with Configit started around 10 years ago when we implemented the first configurator for sales administration and for dealers. That version was based on the VT version of Configit, and it was implemented in a web application provided to our dealers to make their ordering process. Then 1 year later, we released for the end customers a web version of the configurator, supported also by Coolshop, who designed together with Configit a configuration UI simplified and more oriented to the end users that are maybe not that skilled with such complex product. Then another milestone we reached again 1 year after was the release of the first CPQ application. It was the first application that was able to work online but also offline. So the configurator released in this application provides to the sales dealer Salesforce the possibility to configure and complete a quote basically everywhere, and especially when they go to the customers that are maybe in the middle of the field where the internet connection is very poor, or it helps them to have in this application all the functionalities they need to complete their quotation. Then we introduced another element to our landscape, which is the content repository. From here, CNH product specialist can load pictures and other content to enrich the experience of our Salesforce to offer products, so they can also have in the applications additional information to share with the end customer. So basically at this point, we completed our landscape. But due to the strong success obtained with this application, with the sales application, we started receiving a lot of requests to implement new functionality on the application. So at the end, we realized that we had some way to restructure and rebuild this application in order to be able to collect all these new functionality that we collected from the users. So in 2020, we released a brand new sales application. This sales app has been created working very closely with our dealer, with key users, and we spent really months with them trying to design and to find a way to put in this application all the functionalities that they need for their day-by-day activity, trying to also to find balance between the functionalities but also the usability of the app. So at the end, we come out with a unique application that contains both CRM but also CPQ functionality. So for us, it was the first time we put together in a single application all these functionality. So the sales app, as I said, contains, it's like a bridge because it contains from one side all the typical functionalities we had on CRM applications, so the possibility to create opportunity, account, manage contacts, schedule the activity, and so on. And on the other side, it contains also all the typical functionalities of a CPQ application. And while from the CRM side, it is directly interfaced with Microsoft Dynamics. On the other side, we embedded in this application the Config8 platform that provide us that flexibility we needed to manage not only the configuration process, but also other functionalities that really need to have a complete tool where the dealer and their salesman can complete their offering process. So if we look at the platform where the application is has been designed, we have for dealers and for CNH user multiple access point where they can work on. So when they are online, they can work on a web version from their browser. But then the application can be also installed in their desktop as a desktop application, but also on tablet and smartphone for iOS and Android device. So basically, a user can start his job from the browser, but then it can work and continue working on his offer from their laptop or even from a tablet when they are maybe offline. And for what concern the end customer, as I said, we provided inside the brand website a dedicated retail experience where they can search for the most suitable product, configure it, and then contact the dealer available in his zone, and then start the ordering process. So this is basically the landscape and all the platform where the application is available. Then we spoke about the application that should work offline but also online. So the offline utilization was a must So we had to deal with different challenges, meaning when the user is totally offline, we have to limit some functionality that requires maybe a connection with some other system. So when we need a real-time connection, obviously we cannot enable that functionality. So in the app, they are automatically stopped. But then considering also the high amount of data that the application needs to manage in order to provide to the end user so many functionalities, we had to deal with, to optimize as much as possible the data synchronization. So we introduced the concept of live sync, where the application is synchronizing portion of the app in background, so the user can continue working on the application, and during the utilization, the application can download and keep updated part of the application, where, for instance, we have a new version of the product released, or a new content distributed by the product specialist, so the application can continue download the information while the user is still working on it. Then the Configit ACE platform is now our core element that is linked with the sales, the CNH sales ecosystem. As anticipated, the ACE platform is included in the sales application, but it's also part of the dealer web portal, for us it's called eEquipment, but it's also well integrated with the content management repository to receive all contents that are published by the product specialist. It's also linked to our marketing portal to provide users to represent also pre-owned vehicles. It is exposed on the website on the retail configurator, and it is also well integrated with the ERP system. We use SAP, so where the product specialist can enrich the configuration with more description and other information to better describe the product, and for where we take also the configuration rule. And it's also integrated with CRM. So really, the ACE platform is now for us a single source of truth for what concerns the product offering. And since it has been designed in order to be cloud-oriented, it is perfectly matching with the philosophy also of the sales app that has been implemented on a cloud architecture in order to be more scalable and better support the interaction of all these systems. So just to give you some number about the utilization of the sales app, we launched it almost 2 years ago in 5 pilot markets. And in these 2 years, we had almost 3,000 dealers connected, and they created so far something like 96,000 configuration included in the sales offer. And the values of this offer, we try to calculate it, it's around 1 billion. So it is strongly used, and it's again a big success, and we are looking to continue implementing it in the rest of the market. Now, since we have a few minutes left, I will try to present a demo showing you how the configurator looks like in this sales application. So now I'm sharing my screen, and so this is the home page of the sales app application. It is branded, So every brand has its own color, logo, and so on. The user land in this dashboard area where he can see his activity, there are some statistics about the offer done, and so on. So, and if we look at the functionality, we see that we have a perfect mix of CLM functionality, like the possibility to manage account, the calendar, opportunity, and so on, and the typical CPQ functionality, like the model selection, the possibility to see the customer, the vehicle, and the dealer stock, used vehicle, and so on. So now let's focus the attention on the model selection, where we are able to represent the gamma of products offered by Newell & Dagg. All picture and content we see here are coming from the content management repository. And when we have the list of models available, it is also possible to take a look at the key features, so the main functionality of the products that we are going to insert in our offer. So the salesman can be supported on his discussion with the end customer, reporting the main functionality of the product is selected. Then we can select the model, and we can jump in the configurator. The configurator has an area here where we recap the main features and the model I selected. The central part is reporting the product offering. We also have the possibility to enable a chapter navigation in order to better support the selection of some feature. And the feature can simply selected clicking on them. And then okay, we can navigate in the offering. For some feature, we can have also additional content here where for instance, for the 50 km transmission, we can enrich the information reported on the configurator with additional picture and a more complete description. And then when also the user is selecting the option, as explained in some presentation done this morning, we can see, for instance, that the configurator is warning me, saying that we have three additional options selected on the configurator. So clicking on this panel, we can see that in addition to the 50 km transmission I selected, the configurator bring inside also some features, removing what I had in my base configuration. And there are mandatory options that must be selected together with my selection. So the user is continuously informed about what is going on in the configuration, and also which are the conflict on the configuration. So clicking, for instance, on the wheels and tires, I can select again one front wheel. Then the configurator is applying again my selection, is informing me one more time that there are interaction on the front axle and on the rear wheel. So as you can imagine, on the tractor, but also on other complex products, there are so many interaction that an informative message like this one can help a lot the users, not just the end user, but also the salesman, understanding all the constraints and the relation that are among all the options that can be selected. So I selected also my front wheel. And then if I go on the rear wheels, where I saw that there are constraints, I can see that the options that before were available because were part of the offering I have for my market, they are grayed out. And it means that they are not available anymore. So if I, in any case, I try to click in one of these options. The configurator warned me again, saying that the real wheel I selected is in conflict with something that I selected before. So in this case, it is asking me to accept this change. So if I really want this option, I have to remove the 50 kph transmission I selected before, and I have also to remove the front wheel. For the 50 kph, I have only one alternative, so the configurator can immediately select the only available option. For the front wheel, it leaves the selection open because I have more than one option available. In this case, I have two selection, and no one is part of the base configuration. So basically, I have to manually complete my selection. Then I can see that stunting is still missing. I have an alert here saying that the drive line has to be completed, but also the overall status on the configurator is telling me that I have to complete something on the front axle. So clicking there, the configurator brings me on this area, and I can click on the front axle, and finally my configuration is complete. And then if I'm done with my selection, I can add it to my offer and start again. I'm again integrated with the CRM part, where I can look, select my among my available account and continue with the creation of the offer. Now, just to give you the idea about how the offer looks like, is again branded. We have the capability, the possibility to insert again the key feature, explain better the component of the product, and then we have the configuration I selected, and then we have information about VAT or just a recap of my configuration where I can add a discount and something like this. So basically, this was a very quick overview about the tool, proving the flexibility of the application and how we interacted the CPQ and the CRM component in a single application. Thank you for your attention.